welcome to today's class. I'm so happy you're here. We're going to bow in and have a great workout as we start our new cycle. I'm ready if you are. Showed you earlier, we can quickly rotate into our our stance is from this neutral position. Our stance is called a neutral bow. And so we start a lot of our arms. So I want you to rotate your chest all the way toward me. You rotate your back foot and bend that front knee. This is forward bow. Now imagine teacup on your head. Rotate all the way back and bend your right knee back. Keep the chest up and straight. So now our toes are both pointed towards the 45. Now you're gonna rotate all the feet in your chest towards me and lean back a little bit. If you did this movement, you focused on keeping our chest and our teacup on our head, instinctually you came up on your toe. This is your Japanese cat. So let's do that again.
Into our guard stance, we're gonna rotate into a forward bow, rotate into a reverse bow, and then rotate into a cat.
Now that you saw how the body rotates, I'm gonna focus on that. If you have a pillow, don't wear a hat, that's super easy. And don't try a teacup, because, well, that's a little fragile. But so then you have that balance. And for the next minute, I want you to focus on having that on your head and rotate from one stance to another, and then back again. Maybe even sliding in, sliding out. Do it on the other side. That's a good transition for sparring. Next minute, I want you to work on this stance set. So we can focus with the best foot forward and our arms are not out of any trouble, our weapons and our sparring. We're going to take this up. I'm going to step back in my car. So we're going to whip that elbow forward back fist. Come straight out. Rotate that hand to a nice forward bow. And bring it back. And one step, two step. All the way. There you go. Let's do it again. Guard stance. One, two. Here's a roll up. One step, two step. I'm going to have you face a different direction, wall, and I want you to hit some targets. So if a girl's there, a friend is there, with permission, a sibling, when you step back as they're shooting towards you, back as a target that they're holding, punch and holding, and before they grab your hip or your wrist, I want you to one step, two step, all the way. The whole time, focusing on not going up and down, but staying level with your stance. Okay? One, two, keeping it level, hands are up, one step, two step. 60 seconds, go. We're going to take that chair we talked about and put our hand on it. We're going to pick up our leg. Relax. Chill. We're going to pick up that leg. We're going to kick our butt, pointing at the target. The foot that's on the ground, the toes are facing the chair. My knee is facing away from the chair. My hand is up, back straight. I imagine folding pizzas. Remember how early we borrowed something and we used a notebook? We had it on our head. Now we're going to put it on our leg. And I want to challenge you. Pause this video and see how long you can hold it up there. Ideally, more than 3 seconds. But if you want to challenge yourself, pick a time and hold it up there. Be reasonable. Don't pick an hour. And when you're done, put it down and do the other side. And then resume play and we'll see what the next challenge is.
Challenge our kick
to be even stronger with more impact. Go. Feeling more confident using those toes the way they should be. Focus on the little thing. Fantastic. So we're gonna get in that guard stance. We're gonna twist and punch. Boom.
Turn the foot.
Pick up that leg. One, two, three. How many parts of the kick? forward and landing forward. So if you have any like trick or treat bags or trick or treat pumpkins,
I want you to put them down.
One of the book, the book.
How about like a couple of them? You have one foot on one side of it. You're gonna turn your foot, pick up your leg, kick over the pumpkin on the ground, and land over with the pumpkin between your legs. Turn your foot, make sure those hands are up, kick and land with another pumpkin between your legs. If you're very comfortable with that and your grown-up is right there, keeping an eye out, focusing on where those toes are, those hands are,
and the alignment of that kick, I want you to add a move. So you're gonna need your guard stance, forward bow, twist and punch, turn the foot, kick over the pumpkin, land.
Punch, kick over the pumpkin, and land. Hands are up. Go.
I love where we're starting. The next part that we're going to work on today is our weapon tree. Our LA trauma is that speed, that quick, that hands up, that creating distance, that getting away quickly, smoothly, confidently. Our form is actually karate form one. We've got our hands going up, your kicks and punches. We're working on our foundation, having backup mass and staying anchored. That's the concept actually for one. The other part we're working on this month is our nunchucks. We're bringing nunchucks back into this game. So you don't have nunchucks with you right now. Pick some up when you're next time at your class. You know what? You can use a sock. You can use a gourd. Wouldn't recommend it. They do snap. But socks are good. You can really use anything. So take this time, pause the video, go grab what we're going to use for your nunchucks or your nunchucks and come right back.
For athletes, these are ill nunchucks. They do not fold up really high. No, no, no. Because, well, it doesn't really work that way. And if we're blocking something, there's no room there. And we don't hold all the way out here because it's okay to be afraid, but we have to do great. We have to call ourselves to be strong and confident because that's what we were called to be. Conquer our fear. So we're going to hold it in the middle. Just like that. Moving forward. I'm going to have you put both hands in the middle. I'm going to punch straight down. This is ready. So we have our blocks, our push downs. Right now, we're just going to start at ready. I'm going to let go with my left hand and rotate my wrist all the way. And then rotate up. Let go of my left, rotate my palm off my right hand, and right to my shoulder. And rotate back. Okay, now I'm going to do the other side. Drop my right hand, rotate my left hand up. Take this up a notch. Don't let go. Just rotate your right hand up. And give yourself a hug. Roll back. Rotate your left hand. And give yourself a hug. And bring it back. Adult Tang Soo Do concept right here. Every block is a strike, and every strike is a block. Instinctually, it's a strike. But it also can be a block. So for the next 30 seconds, I want you to work on blocking both sides and also striking. Striking both sides. 30 seconds. Go. Thank you. next nunchuck technique I want you to work on, also working that wrist control. Just gonna put it down, keep it loose. I'm gonna do arm circles. Big backwards arm circles. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And bring it in. Relax. Nice, good. Hold the shoulders back. Come back out. Forward circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And relax. And wiggle those chicken wings out. Chicken wing, hot dog in. Chicken in. Chilling with me. Give yourself 2 gloves. Just take it around town right there. Go ready. Pull up your right side. Pull the other hand back. Like we had our check earlier, we're going to hold it up here. High and tight. I'm going to do that forward circle. Without putting our hand all the way up. We're just right here. Keep it up like a chicken wing. 1, 2, 3. And drop it down. Okay, let's do that again. Relax and all cool. Boom. Block. Bring it up. Nice. 1, 2, down. Now we're going to do the backward circle. 1, 2, 3. Roll those shoulders back. Dance it out a little bit faster. I'm going to turn sideways so you can see it again. Block. Arm circle forward. 1, 2, 3, down. And backward circle. 1, 2, 3, up. And then relax. Super fast. Ready? Block. Ooh. 1, 2, 3, down. 1, 2, 3, up. And give yourself 2 claps. You're up for a challenge. This is what it looks like on the other side. Block. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Give you 30 seconds, you're gonna work both sides. And if you're ready for it, add that catch it. Call that a Jedi catch. You just bring it back.
We can just flip it over. Or we can spin it and Jedi. So after you bring it from your shoulder, it's up to you. You gotta spin to Jedi or just flip it into your hand. It's like a dog tail. Dog moves, tail's always connected. So 1 minute, catch to your block. Your forward circles down, your backward circles up, into a catch of some sort.
Well done, athletes. We're going to focus on moving forward, enjoying the spooky season. There's a lot of great things happening at MAK. Keep your eyes open the next few days as all that news comes pouring out, like the ooze of the pumpkin when you're cleaning up the carvings. We'd love to see your carved pumpkins. We'd love to see your faces as you continue growing and being the best version of yourself. So focus on the good, choose to be brave, and we'll see you soon. Let's bow and come back. Ready? Set. Courtesy. Love you guys. We'll see you soon. Bye.